Now let's learn about the life of Subramanya Siva. Before knowing about our leaders, let us see some of their photographs. Any one of you know about him?
We have heard about him, but not in detail.
Okay, listen. Subramanya Sivam, popularly called as Subramanya Siva, was born on 4/10/1884. His birthplace is Vattalagundu near Madurai. He was the son of Rajamayyar and Nagalakshmi Ammal. After completing his studies, he joined as clerk in police department because of the family burden, but he did not like the job. So the very next day, he resigned his job. This was his first and the last job. He got married to Meenakshi Ammal in 1899. In 1906, an orator named Davur Khan Chandra Varma, who belonged to Arya Samaj, delivered a speech in Trivandrum. Subramanya Siva heard the speech. As he was listening, his freedom thought, which was in a corner of his mind, started to aggravate. Travancore province, which opposed this, ordered Siva to leave the province immediately. He started to travel to different places and canvassed against the British rule. Siva was an excellent orator. Younger generation who heard Siva's speech took part in freedom struggle and dedicated themselves. During this time, Siva earned the friendship of VOC. At the same time, Mahakavi Bharati visited Nellai. Bharati too became a friend of Siva. The friendship of these three has an important place in the history of freedom struggle. They were even addressed as Tamil Nadu Trinity. Both Siva and VOC worked together. Because of their activities, the Nellai district had become a base for freedom struggle. British officers, who were afraid of their growing popularity, charged them with various crimes and gave imprisonment. Later, they appealed again and their punishment were reduced. For Siva, they reduced the imprisonment period to 6 years from 10 years. Siva was released on 2/11/1912. After the release, he settled in Chennai. He started to publish his own weekly magazine called Prabhanjamitran and monthly magazine called Jnanabhanu. He travelled to many places and induced the patriotic feeling among people. He never organized public meetings. Instead, he made speeches where there was a crowd. Again in 1919, he started another magazine called India Desandri. During his lifetime, he took part in almost all the conference and struggle movement. Wherever Siva went, he delivered his speech. He was a very courageous man. Siva's speech created mutiny among the people. Britishers who learned this tried to subdue him, and in 1921, he was given 2 years rigorous imprisonment. Because of the tortured life in prison, he suffered from leprosy. British government denied the right to travel in the train, but Siva didn't lose his hope. He travelled by walk or by cart to canvass against the British rule and their atrocity. Siva, who treated his motherland as God, decided to build a temple for Bharat Mata. For that, he laid a stone in his ashram on 23/1/1921. 1923. His health was in very bad condition, as he was continuously taking part in freedom struggle without any break, ignoring his disease. Day by day, his health deteriorated. He reached his ashram in Paparapati on 22-7-1925 with the help of his disciple Sundara Bharati. Youngsters who were willing to do anything for Siva and rich persons who were ready to give anything assembled in the ashram. The very next day, that is on 23-7-1925, Thursday, early morning 5 o'clock, he closed his eyes at the age of 41. Siva, who lived for 40 years, achieved so much. Siva, who fought against the British rule, left the earthly life with many dreams.